£1,200 is $65,000 in today's money.
It's been estimated that she cost him about in the region of £200 million in contemporary money.
The extravagance couldn't last. By the 1930s, the effects of the Great Depression were being felt in London. Selfridges, in particular, was beginning to struggle. The other department stores had copied Harry's ideas, and the competitive advantage had been lost. What's more, Selfridge had made a fatal business error and overexpanded. By 1939, the store was in debt and hemorrhaging cash. But Harry continued to fund his lifestyle and gambling from the store coffers. As a publicly limited company, the board of Selfridges could call an extraordinary general meeting. 80-year-old Harry Gordon Selfridge was told to attend.
The company was in difficulties by the late 1930s, and his personal debts had cost the company considerable money.
He also had debts to the Inland Revenue, which were huge. The board of Selfridges told him he had to pay his debts or go.
Selfridge was demoted to honorary chairman and given a meagre pension.
You can't go on forever, but at that point, in a move that was deeply ungracious and very badly handled, they guaranteed to give him a pension and stripped him of his job. 8 months later, after he kept coming into the store, the staff were embarrassed. His secretary had no letters to send to anybody. He would dictate them, but there was no work for him to do.
By the end, Selfridge almost became an embarrassment to the store. Once they'd taken any managerial authority away from him, they were quite quick to take away most of what he'd been left.
In 1940, the title of chairman was also withdrawn. Selfridge was told he was no longer welcome at his beloved store, but he couldn't let go. He'd travel to Oxford Street every day, simply to stand in the street and stare up at the store he'd built.
People saw him still in his rather smart clothes, then no longer very appropriate, shabby, but kind of, you know, morning suit and top hat, looking at Selfridges, but really outside it and neglected.
He used to count pennies at the bus stop by the Green Man pub to get on the bus from Putney and come to Oxford Street. And in 1943, standing opposite, looking incredibly threadbare, he was arrested for being a vagrant.
Harry Gordon Selfridge died in 1947. Despite all his success, he passed away penniless.
And finally he died, and I think it was a very basic kind of funeral. So it was a sad ending. And he didn't pass on his wealth. I don't think his children were particularly wealthy, because there was no wealth to pass on.
Although Selfridge left no inheritance, his granddaughter Jennifer holds no ill feeling.
Well, I have no problem with that at all. I think my grandfather earned all that money, and he also managed to spend all of it.
But there is a final extraordinary twist to the tale. Jennifer, her siblings, and her mother were always kept hidden from Harry Gordon Selfridge. This private home movie shows Jennifer's parents happily together, as they were for the rest of their lives. Yet incredibly, Harry Jr. never felt able to reveal his wife and family to his father. Jennifer Selfridge never met her grandfather, Harry Gordon Selfridge.
The relationship and we as four children were kept quiet, secret in a way. Isn't that awful? Isn't that ridiculous? It is absurd. But it all worked out. And I'm happy to be descended from him. You know, he made something great, and it's still there. You know, it's still there.
Selfridge's legacy is strong. The store has survived 70 years since he passed. In the Second World War, its deep basements were used to stage secure communications between Churchill and Roosevelt. And from the 50s to 90s, it continued to trade, but it was no longer an industry leader, changing ownership several times. Then, in 2003, it was finally taken back into private hands. The Westons, a Canadian billionaire retail family have rejuvenated the store. Reinventing the Harry Gordon Selfridge formula of interior design and high fashion. Under the Westons, Selfridges is now posting record profits once again. Thanks to Harry Gordon Selfridge, the store still has pride of place on Oxford Street. It stands today as testament to one American's lasting impact on Britain. The secret of Selfridges is out. Harry's American dream is alive in the heart of London.
It has withstood two world wars, and there it is today, full of life with flags flying. And that personality, I believe, is imbued in the building through the force of the personality of the man who built it.
This programme is made possible by contributions to your PBS station from viewers like you. Thank you.
To learn more about Secrets of Selfridges, please visit pbs.org. Secrets of Selfridges is available on DVD. To order, visit